Simi is an amazing Wii U emulator, and it just got an update for Vulkan. So performance for shader compilation will be incredible, and also performance on AMD GPUs is just a lot better. So just let's get into the guide, and when you want to download Simi, go to the site simi.info. And here you will be greeted with this screen. Here just click download latest version, and it will simply take you to the download page. So save it wherever you want, it doesn't really matter. So there are a few things you need to know. Here are some system requirements. These are really minimum, but any modern system should have this. Just know that you do need a pretty fast CPU for this emulator, so keep that in mind. So now while we are here, let's head to the compatibility section. And if you want to know if a game works, most games are listed on here. So for example, Zelda Breath of the Wild, you can just look them up here, and here you can see the game works playable, runs, loads, whatever. So it is a great source to see if a game actually works. So the second thing we are going to download is the Simu hook, and it is an extension for Simu, and it does increase pretty much everything, so make sure to download this one. So here just go to downloads and Simu hook, and you can see the versions right here. So we currently are installing version 1.16.0. And that is the current version which is supported. So just save it right here. And now we are going to the folder where we just downloaded everything. So right here we need to go and extract Simu 1.16. So extract it in a folder. And we're just going to direct the Simu hook zip file onto Simu. And again onto Simu. And here extract the Simu hook files. So there will be a few files, and you can delete the zip file after this, and also the internet shortcut, you could just delete this one. And now you just have these files. So go over and open up simu.exe, and then you will be greeted with the screen of the actual emulator. So at the bottom, you can see we got the Simu plugin, which is Simu hook, and you can click download now to download all the shared fonts. This is so the text works properly in some games. So now this is done, we are going to look at some settings. So first of all, in the file sections, you can load something and install a game update. We are going to look at this in just a second. But next we're going to options, and here go into general settings. Now here are some settings I do really recommend to enable, is automatically check for updates. So if this is enabled, every time there is an update available for you, you can download it automatically, and it just saves a lot of time and trouble. Also, Discord presence, I don't know if you want to enable or disable this, that's really up to you. I'm just going to leave it enabled. So if you want to store the MLC folder in another drive, so this is the location where all the updates and DLC are downloaded and all the save files, you can do that by clicking right here and then select the folder you use. For me, I just use the default and leave this empty. For the game path, here you need to select the folder where you downloaded all your games, so I'm going to click add. And head over to wherever I download my games. Select folder. And now if you close this window, you will see all the games I own pop up in here. And if you double click them, they will launch. But first there are some more settings I'm going to change. I'm going to head to options and again go to general settings. Here in the graphic options is something really insane. OpenGL and Vulkan. So if you're on an AMD or Intel GPU, Vulkan could get a lot higher FPS, so that's great. And if you're on Nvidia, OpenGL may get some more FPS, so keep that in mind. Especially in games like Zelda Breath of the Wild, you should probably get more performance on OpenGL. Just note that, the shader compilation on Vulkan is a lot faster. It is literally night and day. But again, if you got all the shaders already, so you got them from another file, OpenGL will be faster for Nvidia GPUs. But Vulkan is better generally for AMD and Intel users. So first of all, let's go over to the settings. If you got OpenGL selected, you can disable full sync at GX2 draw done. If this is disabled, you could get some more FPS in games like The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Some games do require it to be turned on, so just head over to the forums and check if it needs to be turned on. And if you use Vulkan, I do really recommend to turn this on, otherwise it may be unstable. For the upscale filters, you can pick whatever you want. Some like bilinear, some like nearest neighbor. Just choose whatever you want, it doesn't really matter that much. For the full screen scaling, just keep it at the default. And for the overlay, you can get an overlay which tells you the FPS and all the stats. I'm going to put this in the top left corner. And over here I want to see the FPS, and you can also increase the scale if that's what you want. There are also notifications if something happens, like the controller profiles, low battery, friends list, whatever. I'm going to disable those, but I'm going to enable shader compilation. So now once this is set up, you can go over to audio, and here it's best to select X Audio 2, since it could be a little bit better. If you experience any weird audio issues, you could increase the latency to a bit higher value. But again, if you don't experience issues, just leave it at the default. Over here you can also select all the audio drivers, so if you use the primary one, it will use the speaker which is selected on Windows, which I really recommend. You can change the volume here, and if you use the gamepad audio for the Wii U, you can enable this right here. Over here we got the accounts, and currently I got some defaults set up. You could create an account here and name it whatever you want, so name it TechDunk. And if you press OK, there is a new account called TechDunk. So this is if you want to use multiple saves on one computer. So if I select default, play a game, save it, the save won't show up on the TechDunk account. And if you want to remove something, you just select the account and click delete. Yes. And now the account is deleted. So once here, if you got all the files for online, you could enable the online mode. Again, read the warning, this connects you to official servers and there is a risk of getting banned. But myself, I don't have a Wii U setup, so I can't enable online mode, so that's something for another guide. So let's close this window, and now the performance should already be better, and we're going to improve it even more. But first, let's set up the inputs, so go over to options and input settings, and right here you can set up your controllers. So over here you can make a profile if you want, that's up to you. And here you can select what controller to emulate. So you can use the gamepad, the Pro Controller, Classic Pro Controller, or even a Wiimote. For most games, I recommend to set up a Wii U Pro Controller, since it is quite similar to the Xbox and PlayStation controllers which most of you will be using. If you select this, you can here see the controller API, you can use a keyboard, X input which is Xbox. You can use direct input, and this is for PlayStation controllers. You can use an actual Wiimote and a GameCube. For myself, I don't have a controller hooked up right now. So you can simply click in here and then click the button you want to map to it. So A and S for A and B, whatever. It is really up to you how you want to set this up. If you are going to select a controller, make sure to select the controller in this menu right here to actually get it recognized. And if this is set up, you should be able to control the games, which is pretty useful. So now, one thing which is really great about Simu are the graphics packs. Right here you can see I don't have any downloaded right here, but you can click the button right here to download latest community graphics packs. Right here you can check if you want to see all the graphics packs or just for your installed games. I really recommend to just enable the installed games. So over here you can see all the games you own, and most games just got simple things like enhancements and resolution. And it does say it may not be compatible with Vulkan, but most resolution mods do work with Vulkan, so keep that in mind. But some others may not work with Vulkan, like the bloom adjustment right here may not work. So now, most games are pretty easy to set up, but The Legend of Zelda is another story. So for The Legend of Zelda, there are some settings I do recommend changing. So for example, in the enhancements, you can change all of these. These aren't required, but they could improve your gameplay a bit. For the graphics, you can change the resolution to whatever you want. So for example, you can change it to 1080p, 1440p, whatever you want. And for the shadow, you could increase the shadow resolution, and you can even enable anti-aliasing. There are also mods, which I'm going to show in just a second, but first we're going to cover the workarounds. And as you can see, these workarounds are for OpenGL. So if you're using OpenGL with Nvidia, make sure to enable these two for Intel and these two for AMD. And right here you can see some fixes for Vulkan. So if you're using Vulkan, make sure to select those right here. And if you're using NVIDIA and using OpenGL, make sure to check these four right here. Now for the actual frame rate. Breath of the Wild is kept at 30 FPS, but we can make this a dynamic FPS using FPS++. This is a great graphics spec, and if you're going to use it, just enable all of these and you are pretty much good to go. You can also set the frame rate to a higher limit, so if you want to test performance, you could set it to 165Hz. But generally, stability is the best at 60 FPS, so just keep that in mind. So now the graphics specs are set up, we can close this window again and look at some other settings. So if you right click the game, you can of course select edit graphics specs right here, so you can only see the game you are working on. That could be really useful, but below this is a section called edit game profile. This is a great thing to change the games individually, and you can load your shared libraries and launch with a gamepad view. This is especially useful for games like Sticker Star. And you can also in the mode change the recompiler. So pretty much all games need to be at single core recompiler except for Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. If you're using Breath of the Wild, I will put something on screen right now where you can see what recompiler to use. For my system, it is triple core. But if you're using a low core count system, single or dual core recompiler will be recommended. And again, if you use any other game like Mario Kart, just leave it at the single core recompiler. You can also set the thread quantum to a higher value. This doesn't improve performance that much, but it could get a few more FPS in Breath of the Wild. Also in graphics, I recommend leaving this at the default unless it is stated on the wiki page. And here you can select controllers. If you got some controllers saved, this may help if you're using something like Mario Kart where you need to set multiple controllers. But for Breath of the Wild, just leave it at the default because it is a single player game. So now we are done with all the options, and all of these, I recommend leaving them at the default. So for tools, you don't really need this. For CPU, again, you can change here the mode, but I recommend leaving this one at the single core recompiler. You can also change the affinity. I don't really recommend to use these. If you're using some amiibos, you could scan the NFC tag from a file right here, so you can use amiibos in some games. For the debug, make sure nothing is checked in these settings, so in logging and dump. If any of these settings are enabled, the performance could be a lot slower, so keep that in mind. So don't disable any CPU extensions. From the custom timer, we are going to change this from CMU default to QPC. And in the MM timer accuracy, we're going to put this at 1 millisecond. And the last thing, we are going to use the CMU hook H.264 encoder. CMU has its own encoder, so you don't necessarily need to enable this, but it depends on the use case, and I'm just going to enable this since I know it is stable. So these two settings could improve performance just a few FPS, which is pretty nice, and you aren't going to notice it that much probably, but these should get the best performance. So the last thing I'm going to cover in here is if you go to file, you can install a game update or DLC. As you can see right here, all these games got version 0 or 1 and no DLC installed. And we're going to change this. So go to file, here install a game update or DLC. And then go to whatever you downloaded your DLC and updates. For me, I got a Mario Kart update right here. And go into the meta folder and here click meta.xml. Open this and it will install the DLC or update. It is the same procedure for both DLC and update, so if you can do this one, you can do the other. If it is installed, you can see the success update installed right here. And you can see right here, there's an update or DLC installed for Mario Kart 8, so it does work. And once you want to launch a game, just double click it and it should open. Sadly, because Nintendo takes down most of my videos, I can't show any gameplay. But just trust me, the game does work. And if you want to see another style, you can right click here and select style small icons. And if you got lots of game, this could be a lot better, but for me it doesn't really matter that much. So this is the full setup guide for CMU, and if you got an AMD or Intel GPU, you're pretty much done and can run all the games at maximum performance for your system. But if you're using NVIDIA and using OpenGL, there are a few settings which you could change to increase performance a lot. So if you go to your desktop, you can right click right here and go to the NVIDIA control panel. Here you can go to manage 3D settings, click program settings. Here you can click add. And here at the top you will see the Wii U emulator CMU. So double click this or select add selected program. And here are some settings you could be changing. So if you scroll all the way down, you can here see threaded optimization. Make sure to turn this and this could get a lot more performance. Triple buffering could be turned on for the better performance. And vertical sync, if you use a 60 FPS panel, you could turn this on or at fast. And if you use a 144Hz panel or whatever, you can turn this off. This doesn't really matter that much, but I'm going to turn that off. For the OpenGL rendering GPU, make sure your GPU is selected right here. So for me, it is the GTX 1080. And for the power management mode, it is best to select the prefer maximum performance option right here. These settings should get you a pretty decent performance upgrade. If you click apply, they work. And if you launch a game like Breath of the Wild, performance should be a lot better. So I really hope you enjoyed this guide and I hope you got CMU working. If you got any issues, make sure to let me know in the comments or in my Discord, where I'm pretty helpful and I try to help all of you with all your issues. And I'll see you in another video.